Number 12. Aywa, naam. And that is a hadith an Abi Hurairah radiyallahu an. Qala, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, min husni islami mar'i, tarkuhu ma la ya'nih. Hadithun hasanun, ruwahu tirmidhiyu, wa ghayruhu, hakada. And this hadith is an Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, who we've mentioned his tarjama biography previously, so we won't repeat that. And he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, from the excellence of one's Islam is leaving that which does not concern him. It's him or his leaving of that which does not concern him. And this hadith is in the Tirmidhi and it's Hassan. Again, this is the second hadith which is mentioned in 40 hadith that is not in the Sahihain in Bukhari and Muslim. Regarding this hadith, barakallahu feekum, we're going to mention a few points. An-nuqtatu al-ula, darajat al-hadith, sihat al-hadith. And that is the authenticity of this narration. Khilaf bayn ahl al-ilm, difference of opinion between the ulama. In this hadith, the isnad is al-awza'i and al-zuhri and Abi Salama and Abi Hurairah radiyallahu an. Al-Awza'i and Zuhri and Abi Salama and Abi Hurairah radiyallahu an. This is the chain of narration as found in this isnad that An-Nawawi rahimullahu ta'ala he mentions. And he says, the Tirmidhi said that this is gharib. It's gharib. And the reason being is that there is another chain. And first of all, we must remember that this chain is apparent connected to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it's Abi Salama and Abi Hurairah. But the ulama, such as Imam al-Bukhari, rahimullah ta'ala, and Yahya ibn Ma'in, and Ad-Darqutani, and other than him, and Ahmed, Imam Ahmed ibn Hanbal, rahimahullah ta'ala, they say that this narration by that Nawawi brings here in our lesson today is ma'lul. And that is, there is a mukhalafa, there is a discrepancy as it relates to that chain. And that is that the kibar of the students of Az-Zuhri, they opposed Abi Salama. In that Malik, Yunus, Ma'mar, Rawa, and Az-Zuhri, and Ali ibn Hassan. So Malik, Imam Malik, Yunus, and Ma'mar, they narrated it from Zuhri, from somebody else who narrated it from the Messenger sallallahu, or connected it to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but he didn't meet him, and that's Ali ibn Hassan. Ali ibn Hassan mentioned it and Rasulullah, and Ali ibn Hassan is from the Tabi'in, and he didn't meet the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The companions of Az-Zuhri, as Malik, Yunus, Ma'mar, and Rashid, are the strongest companions of Az-Zuhri, and they did not say it was connected to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the chain that we have here, which is a chain which has Qurra, his name is Qurra, Qaf, Ra, Tamabruta, has Qurra, he says it's connected to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Qurra opposed who? Who did he oppose? Who did he oppose? So we have two chains. One that we have in this collection of An-Nawawi, and that's saying it's connected direct to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Abi Hurairah. Az-Zuhri is in that chain. But there's another chain where the students of Az-Zuhri, who were stronger than the students in the initial chain that we have here, they said it was not connected to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So which one do you think some of the ulama said is the actual chain? The first or second one? The second one. And there was a problem in that one, in that Ali ibn Hassan did not meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So which is why a lot of the ulama, such as Imam Bukhari and Imam Ahmed, Bukhari mentions it in his tariq. He mentions it in his tariq, Kibir, rahimahullah ta'ala. They consider this hadith to be weak. And also Yahya ibn Ma'in. However, that which Sheikh Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala, has compiled this these asanid, and he's come to the conclusion that it is sound, and it is Hassan al-Aqal, it is acceptable. It is acceptable, even though there is that difference in this affair. But no matter how or which opinion that you take, the ulama generally have explained this hadith due to its agreement with the deen of al-Islam. Its agreement with the deen of Islam. So we deal with point number two. Does anyone have any questions regarding that isnad? No. If you don't think it's the Prophet, no. No. But like I said, the meaning is sahih. The meaning is sahih. No. He graded it as, he said it's in his sahih mishkat. No mishkat? No sahih? No. Qurra is in the isnad, in the initial isnad as well. Qurra. Qurra ibn Abdi Abdurrahman. I know. No, because now there is an error. If it's connected, if it's a tabi, and it's saying that I'm Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, now there is a problem in the precision of the whole isnad. Somebody has got it wrong somewhere. So the ulama, they step back in that isnad and see and find out if there are other chains that can support it. And Imam Al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala, has found other chains that support it, so you authenticate it. Point number two. Two or three? Point number two. And that is the manzil of this hadith. The status of this hadith. Qala ibn Rajab rahimullah, هذا الحديث أصلٌ من أصول الأدب. أصلٌ من أصول الأدب. Ibn Rajab. Ibn Rajab rahimullah ta'ala, he said that this hadith is a fundamental from the fundamentals of good character manners. And that is from the Husn al-Islam, the goodness of one's Islam is leaving that which does not concern him. Ibn Abd al-Barr, rahimahullah ta'ala, in At-Tamheed, he says, كلامه هذا صلى الله عليه وسلم من كلام الجامع للمعاني الكثيرة الجليل كثيرة الجليلة في الألفاظ القليلة وهو ما لم يقله أحد قبله والله أعلم. الله أكبر. He said, Ibn Abd al-Barr, rahimahullah ta'ala, that his statement here, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is from that comprehensive, concise statement with a lot of meanings and lofty meanings, with few words. And no one other than him sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said that before. It's a blessing that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam received from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Point number three. And that is the general sharh of this hadith, is that from the muhas in the goodness of someone's Islam, and the perfection of his iman is leaving that which does not concern him in the affairs of the dunya, whether it is from actions or statements. I have a question. In this hadith, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam yaqul min husni islami al-mar'i, from the goodness of one's Islam. Is iman included in this? Is iman included in this? Or is it just Islam? Who says just Islam? Who says iman is included? And why? Ah. إِذَا افْتَرَقَ اِجْتَمَعَ وَإِذَا اِجْتَمَعَ افْتَرَقَ. If it's mentioned separately, then it has the same meaning. But if they're mentioned in the same sequence, then Islam means those affairs of the heart internal, and Islam means the apparent actions. Here, Islam is mentioned on its own. So therefore incorporates iman. So min husni, from the goodness of one's Islam, it means that the believers or the Muslims have different levels. Sahih Allah? So this is a refutation against the murji. So this is a refutation against the murji who says that people's iman is of one level. Because somebody's husn is different from somebody else's husn. Sahih Allah? The level of someone's Islam and leaving of that which does not concern him is different from somebody else's. So in it, it shows that tafadul wa tafawut. It shows that there are differences as it relates to one's level of al-Islam, and therefore, in this, the one's level of al-Iman, al-Rad, refutation against the Murji'ah, who say that Iman is of one level. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala, we say this is point number four. قال ابن تيمية رحمه الله ولا سيما كثرة الفضول فيما لا ليس بالمرء إليه حاجة من أمر دين غيره ودنيا. He said specifically those foolish, yani avoiding those foolish affairs, unnecessary affairs for the individual that he doesn't have a need for in regard his religion and other people's religion and other people's worldly affairs. And Imam al-Sa'di rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, إِنَّ مَنْ لَمْ يَتْرُكْ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ فَإِنَّهُ مُسِيءٌ فِي إِسْلَامِهِ إِنَّ مَنْ لَمْ يَتْرُكْ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ فَإِنَّهُ مُسِيءٌ فِي إِسْلَامِهِ. The one who does not leave that which is understood from this hadith, the one that does not leave that which does not concern him, is harming his Islam. And he harming the perfection and correctness of his Islam. And Ibn Qayyim, rahimahullah ta'ala, he says regarding this hadith. وَقَدْ جَمَعَ نَبِيُّ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمَ الْوَرَعْ كُلَّهُ فِي كَلِمَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ فَقَالَ مِنْ حُسْنِ إِسْلَامِ مَرْءِ تَرْكُهُ مَا لَا يَعْنِي فَهَذَا يَعُمُّ تَرْكُ لِمَا لَا يَعْنِي مِنَ الْكَلَامِ وَالنَّظْرِ والاستماع والبطش والمشي والفكر وسائر الحركات الظاهرة والباطنة فهذه كلمة شافية في الورع. He said, rahimullah, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he combined in this hadith all type of cautiousness and wara, which is connected to cautiousness with taqwa, in one word or in one statement, kalimatan wahida, in one statement. From the goodness of one's Islam is leaving that which does not concern him. And this incorporates leaving that which does not concern him, incorporates leaving statements that does not concern him, leaving, looking at that which does not concern him, enjoying that which does not concern him, holding that which does not concern him, walking to that which does not concern him, thinking and reflecting upon that which does not concern him. All of our actions that are apparent and that are within are incorporated in this hadith. And in fact, he said, it is a statement which comprehensively deals with the affair of wara, of cautiousness. We have some, after this, point number five, some athar from the Salaf as it relates to minding your own business. قال عمر بن عبد العزيز رحمه الله تعالى من عد كلامه من عمله قل كلامه فيما لا ينفعه. Whoever includes his statements from his actions, yani is going to be counted as part of your actions. If he does this, yani he's cautious now because he knows that his statement is part of his actions, then this individual would not say that which does not concern him. Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala qal, alamatu i'radillahi ta'ala anil abdi an yaj'ala shughlahu fima la ya'ni. A sign that Allah has turned away from a slave. Hassan al-Basri, he said rahimahullah, the sign that an individual that Allah has turned away from him is that this slave is made that his efforts and his most important thing is that which does not concern him. And Imam al-Shafi'i, rahimullahu ta'ala, he said, ثَلَاثَةٌ تَزِيدُ فِي الْأَقْلِ. He said, there are three affairs that increases the state of one's aql, improves the common sense intellect of an individual. مُجَالَسَةُ الْعُلَمَاءِ, sitting amongst the scholars, number one, improves one's intellect. وَمُجَالَسَةُ الصَّالِحِينَ, sitting amongst the pious ones, the people who do good, the people of the sunnah, the people who don't waste their time, the uqala, the people who have sense, good character, the people of the sunnah. وَمُجَالَسَةُ الصَّالِحِينَ وَتَرْكُ ثَالِثًا وَتَرْكُ الْكَلَامِ فِي مَا لَا يَعْنِي. And the third is leaving the speech which does not concern him. And Muhammad ibn Ajlan, rahimahullahu ta'ala, from the Talameeth of Imam Malik, was the other way around. قال إنما الكلام أربعة. Verily speech is of four, yani beneficial speech. He says إنما الكلام أربعة, yani beneficial kalam is of four. And تذكر الله, and تذكر الله, and that speech is when you, that is a good speech. Number one is remembering Allah, making dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَتَقْرَأَ الْقُرْآنِ, and you read the Qur'an. وَتَسْأَلَ, وَتَسْأَلَ عَنْ عِلْمٍ فَتُخْبَرُ لَهُ وَبِهِ, and that is that you ask an affair, a question, an affair of ilm, knowledge, and you're informed of that, meaning that the question is beneficial. وَتَسْأَلْ عَنْ عِلْمٍ فَتُخْبَرْ بِهِ. You are asking a question and you're giving the information about that question, meaning that the question is beneficial. مَفْهُوم مِنْ كَلَامِهِ. أَوْ تَكَلَّمَ فِيمَا يَعْنِيكَ مِنْ أَمْرِ دُنْيَاكَ. And speaking of those affairs that concern you, from the affairs of your worldly life. After this, barakallahu feekum, we move on to some benefits. Where's the labas? Let's move on to some benefits of this hadith. The first benefit that we can take from this hadith is that al-Islam yatafawut. General benefits we can take from this hadith. And that is that Islam is of different levels. Everyone's Islam is different. People are of different levels as it relates to al-Islam, and likewise as it relates to al-Iman. Point number two, and that is leaving that which does not concern you in the affairs of the deen and the dunya. Benefit number three, and that is that by leaving that which does not concern you, one has raha. One has raha. One has tranquility. One has tranquility. We have a point here that I want to mention, a shubha that some people, they say. They say that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, from the husn of Islam of an individual, the goodness of Islam of an individual, is to leave that which does not concern you. So therefore, we don't want to talk about Ahlul Bidah. They've got nothing to do with me. We don't want to talk about Ahlul Bidah. We don't want to talk about Ashkhas, individuals, because it has nothing to do with me. This is a Shubha Batila. And that is that Ya'niq. It does concern you. In fact, this hadith is a proof as it relates to the importance of paying attention to the Radood and to the refutations of Ahlul Ilm against the people of Bidah. As this was the way of the Sahaba, radiyallahu an, that they used to ask about the evil things. فقال حذيفة رضي حذيفة رضي الله عنه كان الناس يسألون رسول الله يسألون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الخير وكنت أسأله عن الشر مخافة أن يدركني. The people used to ask the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam about the good things. I used to ask him about the bad things with fear that it was before me. So this is the qaida that we take. Ya'nina. It's from our fear that we have to know those things that are bad. Like Hudhayfa radiyallahu an. Mukhafatan an yudrikni. We fear that it will befall us. As we know from the shi'r, bayt al-shi'r of the poetry of Abi Firas al-Hamadani, rahimullah ta'ala, where he said, Araftu shar, la li shar, walakin li tawaqi, man lam ya'lam shar, or man jahila sharra, waqa'a fi. He said that I know the bad things, not just because it's bad, but rather to protect myself. And who does not know the evil things will fall into it. So in this hadith, that min husn Islam mimari talkum ala ya'ni, from the goodness of one's religion, Islam, is to leave that which does concern him. This does concern us. Knowing about Ahlul Bid'ah does concern us. Because it's a means to protect ourselves from them. Because one of the ways that the people of Bid'ah affect the people is with jahl. When we have ignorance. Ignorance of the usul of the deen, ignorance of the fundamentals of the religion, ignorance of the methodology, the books of aqidah, the books of sunan, filled with defense and refutation against the people of bid'ah. And from the benefits of this hadith is a refutation against bid'ah in itself. Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, min husni islami mari tarki la, from the goodness of one's Islam is leaving that which does concern him. Bid'ah is not from us. So you involving yourself in bid'ah and doing bid'ah, you are doing that which does not concern us because it's not from our affair. Sahih wala. Qala nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Man amila amalan laysa alayhi amruna. It's not from us. Fahuwa rad. So you who fall into bid'ah in your ibadah, in your aqeedah, it shows that your Islam is depleting, the weakening. It shows the weakness of your Islam, la shak. Because min husni islami mar, tarku mala, yani. From the goodness of one's Islam, is leaving that which does concern you. Bid'ah is not from you. It's not for us. Rather, the deen of al-Islam is complete.